out of church working to get ready for church this evening. So I'm glad I got some word in today. I'm glad I got some good praise and some good worship in. I appreciate everybody. I even got some supporters there with me that called me up and said, we want to go with you. You know what I got to say on the day of today, so I appreciate that. Just to give you a rundown of what we got going on today, of course, this is Black History Month. It's February, and it's the month of love. You got, you know, Valentine's Day coming in on the 14th. This is the day we remember all of those who've done things, as we say, as a black race. But that troubled me in the spirit because even still, there is more to us than just the black.
All right.
And the first thing that God gave me on black on this program when I wanted to do it was black history is his story. But his story is not black history alone. God was doing our thing way before they brought us over here on ships. God was doing his thing way before they shackled us and bound us and made us pick any kind to do anything of that nature. God was doing his thing. He lived for us back then and he lived for us now. So I was praying to God and I was asking, where do you want me to go with this? How about me? Do you want me to approach the fact that it's more about you than it is about us?
Right.
As black people, do we get
right to talk about
it? We do. Yeah. We have a pride about it that we're going to call black forevermore. But we still give thanks to a God that we believe died for each and every one.
Yeah. All right.
Not for the black folks, not for the white folks, not for those who were slaves, not those who were slave owners, but for each and every man and woman, boy and child,
that's
God
good.
Died for us.
Yeah.
Sent his son down here. So I write poetry. I used to. That's what I did my entire life. I think I've been writing since I've been talking. And so I really don't remember starting. I just know that I've been doing it. So I said, I want to write something. I wanted to use my little cousins, but it was really hard living the life on your own and trying to get some kids involved and do everything. So God said, just write something. I'll give it to you. You just put the pen to the paper, and I'll bless you from there.
All right.
He blessed me with a young lady I've been known for quite some time.
All right.
Her name is Felicia Moore. She goes to Crawford Park Baptist Church.
All right.
Felicia moved away and went to college at Prairie View.
All right.
Felicia has helped me write this thing from Prairie View.
All right.
On a daily basis. I'm talking, we was up at 1 o'clock this morning writing this thing.
All right. All right.
She said, we going to bed.
All right.
I'll call you at 8. We'll start it again. So at 8 o'clock, we was up again. She was getting dressed and helping me write this thing, so I want to thank Felicia for really helping me. And y'all remember her in y'all prayers. I want to start off, I couldn't title it, but I did. She gave me a scripture that she said touched her when she heard where I was going with it. And it's coming from 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 9 through 11.
All right.
Do you not know that the wicked will not inherit the kingdom of God?
Come on now.
Do not be deceived, neither the sexually immoral, or the adulterators, or the adulterers. Nor male prostitutes, nor homosexual offenders, nor thieves, nor the greedy, nor drunkards, nor slanderers, nor swindlers will inherit the kingdom of God.
Right.
And that is what some of you were. Past tense.
Yeah.
But you were washed. You were sanctified. You were justified in the name of Lord Jesus Christ and by the Spirit of our God. Right. And so what I got from what I wanted to do today was kind of express how we idolize Martin Luther King and Malcolm X, President Obama, because of the education they had, the words they spoke, the actions they took. But the only thing I can think of, he was born just like I was.
Yeah.
He was a man just like I was. He was once a baby just like I was. He's human. So what I want to say is not that Martin Luther King, Muhammad Ali, not that they're not important, but you are just as important in God's eyes.
Right.
And you have just as many opportunities to make a change in this life.
Yeah.
So I'm just being with a guy and say, get out y'all's way. Sometimes we look back, around, or inside, with no luck of finding that honorable measure of pride. A dark past, a cloudy present, and a storm to come. Spoken words of grace, but visions of false hope for some. Idolizing historical figures, and labeling them great. Today I'd like to see how we in this generation relate. Maybe like President Obama, your father just went astray. Or 13-year-old Malcolm X, your father passed away. But love continued to prevail, even when times were hard. Martin and Coretta got married in the front yard. William Lloyd Garrison hustled to support his family. You may be a Sunday school teacher like Frederick Dean, or like President Obama, you did drugs as a teen. So like Malcolm X, your record's not all too clean. History is made in the present, not in the past. It's all about God, and we are all his all-star cast.
Yeah.
There is an audience, but this is no film or play. His spirit directs our actions, and his script what we say.
Right.
Ephesians 6 sets the scene and gives us our wardrobe, not for an Emmy or an Oscar, but heaven as our goal.
Mm-hmm.
But all people that we consider great were just like us before their present state. Mm-hmm. But there's one greater superseding them all. His name is Jesus, who took the final fall.
Yeah.
Joseph and Mary weren't married. And when the unborn Jesus was carried, our Savior was born and delivered in a manger, but his legacy is full of loving those we all call strangers. Mm-hmm. For Black history is his story. Therefore, he deserves all the glory. And despite current circumstances in your lives, you can be great, so continue to strive. And let us all keep hope alive.
All right.
I just wanted to let y'all know that no matter what you're going through, we can all look back and say Daddy wasn't there. Some of us can look back and say Mama wasn't really there like she should have been. I got a troubled past. Malcolm X spent some time in the pen. He was paroled out. He wasn't innocent. He was paroled out. He was more than guilty. But he turned his life around twice. He started off Black supremacy and converted to human rights. He realized that God died for each and every last one of us. What I've been taught is wrong, and I'm turning to the right side. So as long as you make a turnaround, you can make a turnaround in this world.
Right.
But it starts on the inside.
Right.
Give God your hearts, give him your mind, give him your life. I texted a preacher the other day, praying about a situation, and I said that God is the source. And he told me to stay in contact. And I thought he said stay in contact with him. So he said, hey, thank you. And it wasn't until I got off the phone that I said, he may stay in contact with the source.
Yeah. Amen.
Stay tapped into your power source, our Lord Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
And it means so much to me that I share that with y'all, that it doesn't matter what you got going on in your life.
Yeah.
No matter where you come from, how low you think you truly are, God says, I can put enough in you to brave you up.
Yeah.
All we have to do is make a stand.
Yeah.
Like you said, it ain't hard after being a youngster trying to live right.
All right.
It ain't easy at all. It's a difficult task, making a step for God. Especially when so many other people look down on you, consider you stupid.
Yeah.
There's so many easier things to do than live for God.
Talk
but you got
good
thing. Allow God to be that strength in your heart, strength in your mind. Let him speak for you, let him speak through you.
All right.
I was there before I came up here.
All right.
I'm very, very happy. I ain't drinking, but I ain't stumbling too much yet.
Yeah.
But I thank God for that.
Yeah.
I just want to let y'all know that to me, Black history is not made by a man who has education.
All right.
It's not made by a man who is prepared. It is made by somebody who is willing to take a stand in someone's life.
All right.
You need someone who needs help, and you offer that help.
All
you don't wait for somebody better than yourself to come along. You step up for your brother or your sister. And I don't mean physically, biologically. Step up for those that you see are in need.
All
right. We see a life right now, a world that needs some change.
All
we really do. President Obama's in office, but that don't mean nothing much unless we all step up and do our parts. Because you live this life. He's living his, he's doing his part from the White House. Here in Astor, Texas, Waco, Texas, Texas in general, we got to do some things. We got to do some things in our home. We got to do some things in our schools. We got to do some things in our workplace, in our communities, in these streets, in these churches especially. Because this is where it starts at. So we can get it right here and right now, we can make history today.
All right.